أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Month of Ramadan, 40 Ahadees, published by the World Federation. Introduction. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "Those from amongst my ummah who memorize 40 traditions pertaining to those issues of religion which they are in need of, Allah shall resurrect them on the Day of Judgment as jurisprudents and scholars." Reference: Biharul Anwar, Volume 2, page 156, Al-Ikhtisas, page 2. Hadith 1. Why the name Ramadan? Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Surely the month of Ramadan has been named so because it scorches away the sins." Kanzul Ummal, tradition number 23688. Hadith 2. The name of God. Imam Sadiq alaihi salam has said, "Say not, this is Ramadan, and Ramadan has departed, and Ramadan has arrived. For surely, Ramadan is one of the names of Allah the Mighty, the Glorious, who neither arrives nor departs. Surely, arrives and departs that which is ephemeral. Instead, say the month of Ramadan." Al-Kafi, Volume 4, page 70. Hadith 3. The month of revelation of the Quran. Imam Raza alayhi salam has said, "If one asks, why is it that the fasts were made obligatory exclusively in the month of Ramadan and not in the other months? It would be said, this is because the month of Ramadan is the month in which Allah the Exalted has revealed the Quran." Biharul Anwar, Volume 18, page 190. Hadith 4. Reward for recitation of the Quran. Imam Raza alayhi salam has said, "Someone who recites one verse from the Book of Allah, the Mighty, the Glorious, in the month of Ramadan is like one who has recited the entire Quran in the other months." Biharul Anwar, Volume 93, page 344. Hadith 5. Reward of the month of Ramadan. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, "O Prophet of Allah, which of the two months possess a greater reward, Rajab or the month of Ramadan?" Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, "Nothing can be compared to the month of Ramadan in terms of reward." Biharul Anwar, Volume 97, page 49. Hadith 6. The month of God. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "Sha'ban is my month, and the month of Ramadan is the month of Allah the Exalted, and it is the springtime for the poor." Hadith number 7. The chosen month. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "Surely Allah the Mighty, the Glorious has chosen from amongst the months and granted preference to the month of Rajab, Sha'ban and the month of Ramadan." Biharul Anwar, Volume 27, page 53. Hadith 8. The great month. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "Surely the month of Ramadan is a great month. Allah multiplies in it the good deeds, erases in it the sins, and elevates in it the ranks." Wasail al-Shia, Volume 10, page 312. Hadith number 9. the chief of the months. Imam Ali alayhi salam has said, "The month of Ramadan has approached you. It is the chief of all months and the beginning of the year." Biharul Anwar, volume 42, page 193. Hadith number 10, the beginning of the year. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam has said, "If the month of Ramadan remains safe and sound with respect to sins, the entire year shall remain so too." The month of Ramadan is the beginning of the year. Wasail al-Shia, volume 10, page 311. Hadith number 11, the month of mercy. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has said, "It is the month whose beginning is mercy, its middle forgiveness, and its end emancipation from the fire of hell." Biharul Anwar, volume 93, page 342. Hadith number 12, excellence of the month of Ramadan. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has said, "O people, surely the month of God has approached you, the month which in the eyes of Allah is the most virtuous of the months. Its days are the best of the days, and its nights are the best of the nights, and its moments the best of the moments." Biharul Anwar, volume 96, page 356. Hadith 13, the best of the months. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam has said, "The best of the month is the month of God, the month of Ramadan. And the heart of the month of Ramadan is the night of Qadr." Biharul Anwar, volume 93, page 346. Hadith 14. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has said, "O people, surely a great and blessed month has enveloped you, a month in which there is a night, deeds in which are better than that of a thousand months." Biharul Anwar, volume 96, page 342. Hadith number 15, gift of Allah's month. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has said, "Your breath in it is glorification of Allah, and your sleep in it is worship of Allah." Biharul Anwar, volume 96, page 356. Hadith number 16, Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has said, "The month of Ramadan is the month in which Allah, the Mighty, the Glorious, has made fasting obligatory upon you. So one who fasts in this month in a state of belief and with the intention of recompense shall become free of his sins, just as he was on the day when his mother gave him birth." Tahdhib al-Ahkam, volume 4, page 152. Hadith number 17, the month of spiritual striving. In his testament to his sons, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam said, "When the month of Ramadan arrives, exert yourselves, for surely it is in this month that livelihood is distributed, the hour of death is ordained, and the arriving for Hajj is decreed. In it is a night, deeds in which are better than deeds in a thousand months." Al-Kafi, volume 4, page 66. Hadith number 18, the month of good deeds. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has said, "This month of yours is unlike the other months. Surely when it approaches you, It does so with blessings and mercy. And when it turns away from you, it does so with forgiveness of sins. This is a month in which good deeds are multiplied and acts of goodness accepted. Wasail al-Shia, Volume 10, page 312. Hadith number 19, the blessed month. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam has said, surely the month of Ramadan, the blessed month, has come to you. The month whose fasts Allah has made obligatory upon you. In it, the doors of paradise are opened up and the Satan's fettered. And in it is the night of Qadr, which is more virtuous than 1,000 months. Tahzeeb al-Ahkam, Volume 4, page 152. Hadith number 20. The month of Ramadan and seeking forgiveness. Imam Ali alayhi salam has said, it is incumbent upon you to seek forgiveness and supplicate excessively in the month of Ramadan. As for the supplication, by means of it the calamities are warded off from you. And as for the seeking of forgiveness, it erases away your sins. Al-Kafi, Volume 4, page 88. Hadith number 21. Opening of the doors of paradise. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam has said, in it the doors of hell are closed and the doors of paradise opened. Biharul Anwar, Volume 96, page 363. Hadith number 22. The month of Ramadan and i'tikaf. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam has said, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam initially observed i'tikaf during the first 10 days of the month of Ramadan. Later, he observed it during the middle 10 days of the holy month. And finally, he observed it during the last 10 days of the month. And then continued to do so in the last 10 days for as long as he was alive. Biharul Anwar, Volume 16, page 274. Hadith number 23. The month of Ramadan and divine books. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam said, the Torah was revealed on the 6th day of the month of Ramadan, the Bible on the 12th night of the month, the Psalms on the 18th night of the month, and Quran on the night of Qadr. Al-Kafi, Volume 4, page 157. Hadith number 24. The best deeds of the month of Ramadan. During the course of a sermon of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam about the virtues of the month of Ramadan, Imam Ali alayhi salam says, I stood up and asked, O Prophet of Allah, what is the best deed for this month? Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam replied, O Abul Hasan, the best deed for this month is abstinence from that which is forbidden by Allah the Mighty, the Glorious. Biharul Anwar, Volume 42, page 190. Hadith number 25. Losers of the month of Ramadan. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam said, one who perceives the month of Ramadan and does not strive in it and hence is not forgiven, Allah distances him from himself. Biharul Anwar, Volume 74, page 74. Hadith 26. Imam Sajjad alayhi salam and the month of Ramadan. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, with the advent of the month of Ramadan, Imam Ali ibn al-Husayn alayhi salam would cease to speak about anything except dua, tasbih, इस्तग़फ़ार एंड तकबीर। अलकाफ़ी वॉल्यूम 4 पेज 88 हदीस नंबर 27 फ्राइडेज़ ऑफ द मंथ ऑफ रमदान। इमाम बाकिर अलैहिस्सलाम हैज सेड, श्योरली श्योरली द फ्राइडेज़ ऑफ द मंथ ऑफ रमदान possess an excellence over the Fridays of the other months, just as the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam possesses an excellence over the other prophets. Biharul Anwar, volume 96, page 376. Hadith number 28. Seven excellences of fasting. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam has stated, there is no mu'min who fasts for a day in the month of Ramadan with the intention of attaining its rewards, except that Allah the Exalted grants him seven excellences. 1. The forbidden food that had entered into his body melts away. 2. He moves closer to the mercy of Allah the Exalted. 3. Allah expiates his sins. 4. Allah reduces for him the agony of death. 5. Allah protects him from hunger and thirst on the day of judgment. 6. He is granted pardon from the fire of hell. 7. Allah provides him the good and pleasant food of paradise. Mustadrak al-Wasail al-Shia, volume 7, page 395. Hadith 29. The month of patience. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam said, and it is the month of patience, and surely the reward of patience is paradise. Al-Kafi, volume 4, page 66. Hadith number 30. Giving charity. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam has said, Allah shall ward off 70 kinds of calamities from the one who gives charity in the month of Ramadan. Wasail al-Shia, volume 9, page 404. Hadith number 41. Reward of an obligatory act. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam has stated, the reward of one who performs it in the month of Ramadan, a single act from amongst the obligatory acts of Allah, would be like one who has performed 70 obligatory acts in the other months. Wasail al-Shia, volume 10, page 307. Hadith number 32, Night of Decree. Imam Baqir alayhi salam has said, in the night of Qadr is decreed everything, pleasant and unpleasant, obedience and disobedience, birth and death and livelihood, which would occur during the course of that year till the next night of Qadr. Al-Kafi, volume 4, page 157. Hadith number 33. Increase prayers in the month of Ramadan. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam has said, with the advent of the month of Ramadan, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam would increase his prayers. I also increase mine, and so you increase yours too. Tahzib al-Ahkam, volume 3, page 60. Hadith number 34. Eating of Sahur. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam has said, eat your Sahur, even if it is mere mouthfuls of water, for the blessings of Allah are upon those who eat the Sahur. Tahzib al-Ahkam, volume 4, page 198. Hadith number 35. Hunger and thirst of the Day of Judgment. Imam Ali alayhi salam has said, bring to mind by means of your hunger and thirst, in it the hunger and thirst of the Day of Judgment. Bihar al Anwar, volume 93, page 356. Hadith number 36, the call of Allah. Abdullah bin al-Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib reports that he heard the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam say, every night in the month of Ramadan, Allah, the Blessed and Exalted, calls out three times. Is there one who seeks from me so that I grant him his wish? Is there one who turns to me in repentance so that I turn to him in mercy? Is there one who seeks forgiveness from me so that I forgive him? Mustadrak al-Wasail, volume 7, page 429. Hadith number 37, Ghusl on the night of Qadr. Imam Musa bin Jafar alayhi salam has said, one who performs the ghusl on the night of Qadr and remains awake in it shall have all his sins forgiven. Wasail al-Shia, volume 10, page 358. Hadith number 38. Shield of a believing servant. Allah the Mighty and the Glorious has said, the fasts are the shield of the believing servants on the Day of Judgment, just as your weapons shield you in this world. Wasail al-Shia, volume 10, page 403. Hadith number 39. Iftar for a moment. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, one who provides iftar to a mu'min in the month of Ramadan shall be granted the reward of liberating a slave and shall have all his previous sins forgiven. And if he did not possess the means to present anything except milk mixed with water or a drink of sweet water and a date, Allah would grant him this reward. Bihar al-Anwar, volume 93, page 317. Hadith number 40. Farewell to the month of Ramadan. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam prayed, O God, ordain not this month of Ramadan to be the last one of my fasts. But should you ordain it to be so, then make me blessed and leave me not deprived of your mercy. Adab al-Quran, page 398. Allahumma shalli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajjil farajahum.